audience here. Peter Tobin. Not here yet? Okay. Well, our next guest speaker is Linda Gasser. And she became involved in the Durham Residual Waste Environmental Assessment in 2006. A longtime Clarington and Durham Region Council watchdog, Linda has also advocated for sustainable land use and transportation policies with a focus on protecting the natural environment, public health, and local agriculture. In 2008, Linda joined Prevent Cancer Now, which I happen to be on the executive board of, and she's done a great job as the national incineration campaign coordinator. She developed an incineration toolkit to help ordinary citizens to learn about the range and risk associated with burning garbage. For that, thank you, Linda, and she's gonna have some words for you.
Yay, Linda!
Yay! Bravo!
Thank you, Dave. Good morning, everybody. Thanks for coming. Prevent Cancer Now's mission is to build a Canada-wide movement.
You gotta get closer.
To eliminate the preventable causes of cancer. One of the ways is with education. In 2009, we posted our incineration toolkit online. This toolkit allows ordinary citizens to become informed. That knowledge empowers you to advocate effectively to protect your families and communities. With the knowledge, you can urge your community leaders to move towards safer and more sustainable waste strategies. In British Columbia this past spring, residents of Kamloops and Christina Lake mobilized, and two incinerator proponents withdrew their proposals. We can do this too. With knowledge, we can debunk the incinerator industry myths. There is no evidence that modern incinerators are safe. That is one big myth. In 2007, Halton Region was considering a massive incinerator. Given an already burdened airshed, and in the face of informed citizen opposition, and because of the precautionary approach adopted by their medical officer of health, Halton Region Council opted not to proceed with incineration.
They were smart.
In Durham Region, with that same information, and also with evidence of a heavily polluted airshed, Durham Region councillors nevertheless voted to forge ahead, based in large part on the opinion of Durham's medical officer of health.